Shalom. We GMS Louisiana Saints come at you once again with another Parish Topics. As always, we'll give all praise to Yahweh,
Hashem, Yahweh Shai.
Double honor to the elders of GMS, peace and blessings to the Akim, but I like that labor and truth and sincerity, man. Shalom. Give me that Zephaniah. All
right. Zephaniah 1:10. It say, and it shall come to pass in that day, says the Lord, that there shall be the noise of a cry from the fish gate.
Right, it said there's going to be a noise of a cry from the fish gate, man. That's for me. The fish gate represents Wall Street. The big bankers, the big tycoons, that's on Wall Street, willing and dealing this money, it's going to be a cry heard from them, man. And the fish gate represents, you look at that stock market, it looks like a... But go ahead, I'm kind of getting my head of myself.
It said, and a howling from the second.
Right.
And a great crashing from the hills.
Yeah, great, that's the part I want. The great crashing from the hills. Because you look at that stock market and the diagrams and the graphs, yeah, look like hills. They say, this hill going to crash though, man. Okay, it's going to be a howling and cry. Them people on Wall Street, a lot of them, they're known for blowing their own brains out, man.
Yeah.
And we really getting on this, really we getting... We land backing on this government shutdown. It's evident what's getting ready to happen. It's right before your face, man. What's another term? The elephant is in the room. You niggas can't see it, man. Okay, go ahead, huh?
How ye?
He said, how ye, man? Go ahead.
Inhabitants of Mektesh.
Inhabitants of Mektesh, go ahead.
For all the merchants, people are cut down.
Right.
All they that hear silver, Tulaki, all they that bear silver are cut off.
Right, and Mektesh was known for money, man. You know, that's today's Wall Street, okay? All that silver, gold, that money is going to be cut off. Well, I told that damn guy out there, you're going to better wipe your ass with these greenbacks, man, in these coming days. You know, there ain't going to be no such thing as Bitcoin's going to crash too, man. Okay, that's money that's made out of nothing. It's gonna crash. All these this government is gonna crash, man. Your new currency is gonna be the mark of the beast, man. Yeah. No, it don't matter what them guys are to tell you about being an embargo, about being Christianity, John 3:16. No, it's the chip, the mark of the beast, man. It's gonna be forced on a lot of you people. It's gonna be voluntarily, then it's gonna be forced on you people, man. Okay, go ahead, huh? Go down to 12, huh?
All right, it says, and it shall come to pass at that time that I will search Jerusalem with candles and punish the men that are settled on their leaves.
Right.
That say in their heart, the Lord will not do good, neither will he do evil.
Right, man. And the Lord gonna punish them niggas, man. That's out there telling the people that's out there saying that, man. But the days of evil is getting ready to come, man. I mean, gruesome. You know? The days of coming gonna get gruesome. I'm talking about what the Lord, the one in, I think it's Isaiah, the 13th chapter, said the Lord coming both cruel. And one of y'all can get that, man. Yeah, man.
Cruel and furious.
Yeah, with fierce anger, man. The Lord ain't playing with you niggas, man. And you Latinos, Native Americans, so-called Negroes, and you fucking heated, man. And I'm getting straight, man. Because you niggas think it's a game out here. Go ahead,
Because if I can say, they depend on the stock market. You know what I mean? They depend on the dollar sticking around. Because, you know, Jake ain't shit without pulling the pile of money to their ear and talking to her.
That's going to be old with, man.
You know, Jake ain't shit without pulling out money at the strip club and dashing it all around like they some goddamn man of the year.
It's gonna come the day when you niggas gonna be out here homeless, burning money. And I got, remember, you watch Home Alone, you watch the motherfucker gonna be burning that shit, burning it, having a fire, trying to keep warm with, man. Making a fire to try to cook a pigeon or some shit that day, man. You know? A fucking squirrel you done caught. You just said that?
I was gonna say, Jake said it on the
news. Yeah, you
know,
man.
They,
that's
they,
you.
They lost this curve, man.
All right, so. It's Isaiah 13:9. Behold, the day of the Lord coming cruel. It's a lot. The day of the Lord coming.
cruel, bold, with wrath and fierce anger.
It's how the Lord coming, man. It's wickedness, man. It's wickedness, man. It's straight wickedness, man. Well, come here.
To lead the land desolate, he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of it.
Lay the land desolate, man. Destroy the sinners thereof out of it, man. That's what the Lord coming back to do, man. Go ahead, Al.
This is second Ezra chapter 6, verse 22. And suddenly shall the sown places appear unsown.
Right, this is gonna happen when this collapse comes, man. When this shit goes belly up. Go ahead. The full storehouses shall be suddenly found empty, man. Your Walmarts, your Costco's, all those different stores you love to go to, they're gonna be found to be empty, man. You know, you ain't gonna better go in there and get your water. You ain't gonna better go to get your Starbucks and different places like that. Popeye chicken, you niggas love McDonald's, man. McDonald's, they're gonna be so fucking close, all the Golden Arches gonna be on the fucking ground, man. You know, you niggas it's gonna be bad out here, man. Go ahead, huh?
That was it, man.
Yeah, man. This collapse is getting ready to gonna bring, man. Go ahead,
huh? So you know the nigga woman gotta buy that weed.
Yeah, you ain't gonna buy that weed no more. Yeah, you think we playing? Go read Isaiah the 3rd chapter for you women, man.
Yeah.
That's how you gonna be.
They head covered in that day.
Shit, they ain't gonna have no help, man.
That's why I say they gonna keep it covered.
Right. Go ahead, huh?
Just backing up what you just were saying about the crash. This second Exodus 15 and 19. A man shall have no pity upon his neighbor, but shall destroy their houses with the sword and spoil their goods because of the lack of bread.
Yeah. A man ain't gonna have no want on his neighbor, man, because there's gonna be a lack of bread. A man gonna rob you, man. Mm-hmm. My man might hold your kids for ransom just to get bread and water and from you. Because the new currency is going to be bullets, bread, water, food, canned goods. What's some other things, man? Kotex going to be the next currency.
Just imagine.
Everything.
Tissue papers.
Soap. What you think going to happen if they got a shortage of food? Everybody looking for some food, and somebody just smell somebody cooking something.
Oh yeah, they gonna pounce on that guy.
Two things gonna happen. They coming through there.
Oh, they going. They all the
front window, side window, kicking down doors. They coming in there.
Yeah, they gonna come in like Salsa came in Tony Montana house, hopping on the gates and shit.
There ain't gonna be nothing you can hide. It's gonna be family members,
right?
Close friends.
I was going to say, elaborate to what I was saying about how hard people going to be trying to get there. They the back of their foot going to be touching their back. They're going to be running so hard that day, man.
Right. This is going to bring a full collapse, man. A full famine of the world. A full actual famine of bread and water. You know? This thing is going to bring a total chaos, man. Read about the season of Masada, man. That's how it's going to be for you, Jason. We was laughing because they had a big ass rat in the street dead. Oh, see, the niggas gonna pounce on that day, man. Niggas gonna pounce on that.
That's gonna be good eating.
Well, you niggas already down here eat fucking anything. You know, Nutri-Rat niggas ride down the street in the country and hit some shit. It's, get a goddamn shovel and put it in the back of the truck.
Boy, teach me how to make that big chicken.
Yeah, man. Yeah. Fucking coon and. Yeah. How you eat a goddamn armadillo and shit? You niggas eat anything, man.
Yeah, eat anything, man.
You know? But go ahead, man. We plan. We making mockery of it, plan about it. But it's true, though, man. Okay? Go ahead, huh?
This is Matthew 24 and 21. For then shall there be great tribulation, such as was not since the beginning of the world to this time.
That's right, man.
No, nor ever shall be.
Right. This is how bad it's gonna be, man. That you can put the slave trade, the siege of Masada, all that. That's little shit compared to what's getting ready to come, man. You know, we play these video games. You see. Total collapse where they have cars in the street, people dead, trash everywhere. That's how it's gonna be, man.
Division.
Right, the division. Yeah.
A little move in the road.
Right. That's how it's gonna be, man. Right. Go ahead.
This is Luke 21 and 20. And when ye shall see Jerusalem compassed with armies, then know that the desolation thereof is now.
Right. And it's all tied to this government shutdown, man. When we open it, these devils, man, go ahead with their move, man, on you people. It's going to happen anyway, whether it be now or later. It's going to happen, man. Go ahead.
This is 2nd Address 16 and 71. They shall be like madmen, sparing none.
Yeah, he's talking about these stormtroopers, man. These private military that's going to come and wage war in your city against you. Against you women, you kids, you men. They're going to come like madmen, sparing none. You don't understand the foreign language that I'm saying? I'm telling you, get down. You don't get down, I'm gonna shoot you. Okay? Kids and all, man. This is how they coming. Go ahead.
But still spurling and destroying those that fear the Lord.
Yeah. Because who the ones that really fear the Lord? Jake. Jake the really ones that fear the Lord, man. Jake, even in his docile state, hit his toe on a goddamn countertop, on the bottom of the countertop, on the end of the bed, or find $200. They don't get praise. Oh, thank the Lord I found $200. I don't need that.
Oh, guess what? When Jake gets stuck in tribulation, Jake get caught and Jake facing 10, 15 years in jail, or he's gonna become the most religious person in the world.
Right. So you the ones that fear the Lord, man. Right. Go ahead. Yeah, right. Just pray for me.
Yeah, that's Jake.
That's what niggas be saying. Go ahead.
I believe in something if you got somebody to pray for me.
Right. Go ahead.
But they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out their houses.
Right. Cast you out your house. Go ahead a little more.
Then shall they be known who are my chosen.
Right, we gonna hit it on that, man. Then it shall be known who are my chosen. All these goddamn guys playing around with you, playing around with the doctor, acting like they ain't really in it. Really not, like that guy earlier from DC was talking about, acting like they're really in it, but they're really not. They really don't believe, they really don't have no faith. It's gonna be known who's faking the funk, man.
Yep.
Okay? And the Most High gonna get you, man. He gonna drop a bomb on you like Funk Master Flex, okay? Yeah. The Most High gonna drop something on you, man. All that playing you niggas like to do. Chucking the jobs and thinking this truth is for a play. Yeah, everything a game. You gonna find out, man. That's it on that, huh? So with that, man, you know, we gonna give all praise to y'all.
I will.
Go on to the elder GMS, peace and blessings to Akim, and out there labor, truth and sincerity, man. Shalom.
Shalom.